With summer now officially underway, it means lots of outdoor activities, including picnics, camping, and more. But insect bites and stings can really bug your little ones. Here with us today is Dr. Amkem Howey of Iowa Health Des Moines to help deal with the pesky critters. So how do we keep these critters out of our house and our yard? What's the best way?
I think the best thing is prevention, and the way you do that is keep them away from your surroundings in your house. A couple ways to do that. First and foremost, keep your lawn well manicured. If you keep your grass cut short, that the bugs don't like the short grass. Second, if you have debris in your yard, piles of leaves, etc., get rid of that debris. And then finally, if you can get rid of standing water,
sure,
that's really helpful.
Yeah, with the mosquitoes especially.
Yeah.
Well, we always hear a lot about ticks, and when you hear about ticks, you hear about Lyme disease. So what should we know about that?
Well, two things to keep in mind with Lyme disease. First of all, you have to get bit by a specific tick called a deer tick. That's the size of the head of your pen in your pocket. So very small, not the usual wood tick. Second, it has to be infected with the bacteria that can cause Lyme disease. If you suspect that has happened and you start to begin to notice a rash in the area where the tick bite was located, an annular rash, it's almost like a bullseye, and also you start developing flu-like symptoms, you know, achiness, you have swollen glands, fevers, etc., you might want to see your doctor, because if you can get on medication early, that'll help get rid of the infection.
Well, as with any illness, we always like to talk about prevention. So what's the best way to prevent stings and bites from insects?
Well, first and foremost, as I mentioned, you know, make sure that you keep your yard clean. Second, light-colored clothing is helpful. Fabrics that are very light-colored, that way you can identify them quickly if the bugs are on your clothing. Plus, they don't like light-colored clothes. Second, avoid perfumes and colognes. They like scents, and they're attracted to that. And then finally, bug repellent. If you're going to be out for several hours, you'll have to reapply it every few hours. Particularly with kids, remember to use the DEET formula, less than 10%, because that can be adverse to the kids if you use higher concentrations than that.
All right. Dr. Amkem Howey, as always, thank you for being with us and helping us take a little bite out of summer. For more health topics, click on our website, kcci.com.